Hi everyone, welcome to the part 2 of React blog application. Let's first have a look on to the APIs which we have created. So I will just go through one by one. This is the post where we are actually creating users. Okay, so here we can pass the unique username, first name, last name. It should be first name. I will actually control Z. Okay, this is how we are creating a user. And then this particular user can be used, can be passed to blogs while creating a post. Okay, this user, now we have another route. What it is doing is it is creating posts. Okay, and here we can just change it to title and content. I'll just change it title and content because this is what we need to create a blog post. It is having just a simple string, whatever you can put. Title equal to my blog on Node.js. Okay, this is how we are actually creating a new blog post. And if we do a get, we will able to get this blog post, and this is the user ID. This is the post ID, and you can see the owner of that blog information is also being populated. Similarly, you can get all the users information. So we have two users in the system. We are now getting the detailed proper response from the APIs. Now what we need to do is, in the previous video we were setting up the React Bootstrap. So first of all, in the package.json we can include the React Bootstrap and Bootstrap. Okay, now we can start writing our component app.js. Let's have a common header component. So what we can do is, in src we can create a component. Here we can create our reusable components, like I'm going to have header.js, and whatever the code we have right now we can move it to a header component, because this is more like a header. Export default header. And we can also have some kind of a routing in this component. Okay, now app.js, here we can import the routing. Import the header component and then set up some kind of a routing. Here I'm importing header. Okay, here is the header component, and I'm rendering only header component for now. Right, so other components, what you can do is you can wrap first of all this inside react.fragment, and you can put everything. We can have a lot of other types also, like containers and all, because now we are using React Bootstrap. So we will be using container and row column class structure. So this is the header. Then we will be having one common component, which is a body. Okay, you can see this is a main container, another component, and we can actually create main.js in the component, or you can say the home.js can have same as header for now, and here we can say home. Home component. Now we are exporting this as a default, so we are importing it everything here. Component, and here we are importing home component. This is how we create a simple parent child component. Now, you can just, this is the default export import, so you can put any name. Okay, you are importing main header component and main container component. Main container component will have your lot of other things. So let's decide what we can put in the main component. We can have some kind of a jumbotron, right? This will have the basic things, so we can import it in our home component. I can have jumbotron, and I can just import it. Okay, now you can see how it look like. Okay, So we are able to see the Hadoop component working. Now we can also see what other layouts we can use. We can also add footer and all these things. So this is how you can add your components, right? Now we need a container component where we are actually going to do all these things. So container.js, and we'll place whatever is in the header for now inside a container and we'll replace it. Here we are going to have a form because we need to do the user registration in the first place. So we will just get the forms, and this particular form is fine. We will import the form. So this is pretty much straightforward now. And this is nice. If you are using some kind of a library, then it is very easy to write components quickly. This is why I'm using here this form component. I'm in the React Bootstrap and I'm using the navbar, container, everything from this React Bootstrap. We can also have a container, which is also coming from React Bootstrap. So we can wrap it inside a container and row column. Inside container, we can have a row. For now, it's a form component, and we will put this form component inside our container. Just do the formatting. Okay, it is filling up. Okay, so now we have created basic form. We have to render it somewhere. So this is, you consider that this is a container component we have created. Okay, this container component we are exporting, and we will be importing this container component in app.js. So consider it like container where we will be doing a lot of things. We are getting it from the home container, and here we can import the container component inside this main container. I mean main container, we will remove the main container because it's not being used. It's just to show you how it looks like. Now button is not defined where in container.js, so we'll also add button in our import definition. Now it should work. Okay, duplicate declaration of container. Why? Okay, container component, let's rename it because container is already a import in the declaration. Okay, now you can see, we can see this basic simple form, right? Now what you can do is you can actually just decrease the width of this particular form. We can use a row column classes. Here we have to use this bootstrap row column classes, and here we can divide how much you are going to occupy. So if we just look at the documentation, then we will come to know how we can divide our form components into the row column structure. Coming back here. So that should be coming in the layouts. So let's go to overlay pagination. So it's a React Bootstrap. It's going to be work same as the Bootstrap framework we have, but only the props, what props we need to pass, that we have to see. So I was looking for layout. Okay, in the layout, I think we should see something. Okay, these are the row column classes. So if you want one column, two column. So here you can provide row and what, how many columns it is going to occupy. So inside row, you can say, so excess extra small columns will be this, empty columns will be 6, right? And we can just create a closer of this in outside the form. What is not closed? So column we haven't imported, so we can import one column. Okay, now things should be good, I guess. So we are using the React Bootstrap. Row is not defined. Yeah, you can see now that is coming in the first 6 columns, right? You can also provide a spacing. So spacing is also there, like you can provide a spacing of 3 columns from the left and 3 columns from the right. You can just put an order here. Here, like if you want to offset, you can provide. You can see, like offset, if I put 3 offset from the left and 3 offset from the right, then I can use something like this, MD span 3 offset 3. Span will be 6 columns, but offset will be 3, means 3 columns from the left. So now it should be centered for us in the medium layouts. Yeah, this is clear. Okay, there is additional column. Now we have created a basic form. What we can start writing is, we can create a user. So for user, we just need a 2 inputs. Email address, okay, first name and last name, because it's a basic API. First name, and we have last name, and we have username. So I think we can make the first one as a username. This is our first name, and we can have one more form group form control. So here form group, I mean, what all things you need to create a control, form group opening and closing. So we can create one more, which will be just nothing but first name and last name. So this is the basic form we have created. Now what we will do in the next video is, we will be capturing the values which is being entered in this form, and we will be submitting it. So this is first name, this is the last name we have entered, and there is a submit button using which we will be submitting the values. So enter placeholder is enter username. We are removing this helper text, we don't need it. Okay, so let's see in the next video rest of the part.